Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Justin Perkins to the blue corner.
And in our next bout coming up, we have the most experienced fighter on the card, Justin Perkins out of the MMA lab, coming in with a record of 3-5-1-1. MMA lab, well represented on this card as usual. Tremendous combat sports gym. And Justin Perkins looking to make his name known in the Premier Fighting Alliance. Last checks by the referee.
Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome his opponent, Yuki Wang, to the red corner.
And making his way to the red corner out of Paradox MMA, second consecutive bout featuring a fighter from that gym, Yuki Wang. No walkout song, all business.
These guys always come in with a different type of mindset.
They've got something going up there at Paradox. In his corner is our current
Ladies
champion, Isaac McCary.
Your 12th bout of the evening takes place in the welterweight division, has K-1 rules, and is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. In the blue corner, with an amateur record of 3 wins, 5 losses, 1 draw, and 1 no contest, with an official weight of 147.6 pounds, fighting out of MMA Lab in Glendale, Arizona, introducing Justin Perkins.
Again, fight fans.
His opponent fighting out of the red corner with an amateur record of 3 wins and 3 losses, with an official weight of 145.2 pounds, fighting out of Paradox MMA in Las Vegas, Nevada, presenting Yuki Wang.
Where are you going?
And in this next bout, we have the MMA Lab taking on Paradox MMA, two tremendous gyms. And this is our most experienced. Wow, what a head kick.
I was just going to say, I don't expect a fill-out period in this one.
Well, this is the most experienced fight of the card we have, a combined 16 bouts between the two of them. And these boys are getting after it like it's their debut here. My goodness.
Right. Ooh.
Hands down, lunging in from Wang. Wow. Long hook to the body. And honestly, it seems like Perkins is trying to, you know, settle in there and find his range, because Wang is just throwing everything in the kitchen sink at him.
Sometimes, you know, it throws guys off when they come in like that. They're yeah. so not used to it.
Oh, good knee from Perkins there. He's almost crow hopping into his overhand there. He's got to be really careful he doesn't get caught on the way in. Oh, massive body punch there.
Wang is putting a lot of pressure on. Like I said, his style is a little unorthodox for most people. However, those hands, I always pointed them out. They're down, man, and
he's got 3 wins, so he clearly does something that works in here. Although, like I said, his lunges in with his hands down could end up costing him.
Yeah. He's caught that foot 2 times in a row now.
Well, again, that's what happens when you throw the same kick over and over again. If your opponent is skilled, they will pick up on that and start to catch it. Oh, good jab there from Perkins. Good low kick. Again, I think what we're going to need to see is just Perkins getting the timing down. And with Wang's style, it seems that he might end up running into offense with the way he's lunging inwards.
Right, right. And especially, like you said, that timing factor, because he's throwing the same thing in the same style. He's not setting up anything
good
at the current moment.
Body from Perkins there. Big overswing, but now he's starting to move forward. Sorry to cut you off, but yeah, absolutely. You know, it takes some time to get something unorthodox, or somebody who is unorthodox, get their timing down, you know, because you know, you're not used to seeing fighters like that in the training room.
Right. And that's why I said sometimes fighters take some round or so to really understand and zone in on what that fighter is doing.
Absolutely.
Being technical is one thing, but when you're so non-technical, it can actually turn into an advantage in some way, sometimes.
Absolutely. Again, there's a way to be unorthodox, but you have to still be defensively responsible. That's the one thing I was looking at in that first round is Wang. Like I said, he would shuffle step in with his hands down, and a good fighter will catch you on the way in with a good hard punch or a kick, and, you know, looking for a little bit more defensive responsibility here in the second round.
Right, right. It's definitely something that we're going to be paying attention to this round. See if that's something that Perkins is able to catch on to. Obviously, in that round, I'm going to have to give the edge to Perkins.
I would say, despite the volume clearly going to Wang, Perkins did land the better shots, and you felt the momentum shift there a little bit at the end. He was starting to move forward, put that pressure on. So let's see if it carries over here in round number two.
We've seen crazier decisions tonight.
Yes, we have.
Ooh, oh, nice spin.
He turns his back, almost a spinning back fist attempt.
Right.
See, right
nice
there.
Body kick.
He committed to a kick but didn't throw it and left himself out of position where Perkins is able to land the shot. Perkins finding his range here. Good body kick there from Wang. Oh, and a jumping switch kick. Not the first time we've seen that tonight. Oh, beautiful clinch into a knee. Wang flying around like a whirling dervish out there, throwing all sorts of offense. Hook kick.
Take it to me.
He's got his hands down. Spinning hook kick attempt from Perkins there. And Perkins,
a lot of action in this round.
And another thing, you got to think about the effect on the cardio all these big movements have from Wang.
Right.
Oh, and he uses the fence to stay standing on the kick.
That was nice.
That was beautiful. Perkins just slowly but surely adding up the shots, you know.
Yep. And then that's another thing, too, with all that extra movement that Wang is giving off, all that extra energy he's exerting.
You can see movements are looking a little bit labored now. Good jab lands for Perkins, landing those low kicks. Oh, and there's a combination there in the fence. He's got him wobbling. Great job by Perkins there. Lands a knee to the chest. Deep kick. He's controlling the pace, the range, and the offense here now. Big overhand swing by Wang. Both these men starting to show some effects of fatigue. Good knee to the body there from Perkins. And we have 10 seconds remaining in the second round. Oh, you're really seeing the fatigue now here, James. Oh, and Wang gets the sweep.
That was a nice catch by Wang.
Yep, and that will signal the end of round number two.
It's really
weird. Round there.
Because Wang's offense is actually starting, because of the fatigue, it's starting to turn into almost some defense for him as well.
Well, again, unorthodoxy, it goes in both ways. If you're not in the normal position to get hit like other people, the shots aren't going to land as clean. And also, if he's used to fighting with this style, his cardio is probably going to hold up a little bit better. And having somebody throw these flurries at you where you don't know where the punches are coming, it is exhausting both mentally and physically to be in front of that. So it's going to be interesting if Wang can keep that pressure and momentum here in the third round.
I definitely agree with the fact that I was a little surprised in this round how the fatigue has settled in. I thought I would have seen a little bit more showing from Wang's side, but Perkins trying to hang with him and, you know, roll with the punches, so to speak, has worn on him over time.
Oh, a strong low kick to start the third round from Perkins there.
Nice straight.
And, you know, you see something just technically that I noticed between these two guys. When Perkins throws a kick, he returns back to his stance immediately. He's ready for more. Wang, he'll throw a kick and almost take a second to reset, which gives Perkins a chance to control the exchange.
And
big punches there. He's got him on his heels now.
And I think a lot of that is contributed to the fact that his feet are so out of place when he's when he's throwing.
And look at that swing. That punch was coming from
caught.
Avondale there. Oh, and Perkins
now
putting
Perkins
it together
is,
once
is getting
again.
That timing now.
Yep. Strong break from the referee there, using her muscle in there.
Oh,
spinning back fist to the body from Wang, and he tries it again, and almost a rear naked choke attempt from Perkins there.
These two are really going at it now.
We have plans to get into the MMA space, but tonight this is still kickboxing, so no chokes for any of these guys. Good body
nice
kick.
Nice exchange there.
Oh, that was
caught him with the elbow.
That was a spinning elbow. Accidental, of course, but that did appear to catch Wang. Ooh. Oh, and he swings.
Swinging for the fences.
I think it's nice interesting how the more tired some fighters get, the more they want to spin. I don't always see the use in it, but it's where we are.
I liked Wang's ability to stay on his feet right there on that attempt sweep. Nice way for Perkins to stop that.
Yeah. Hey, you don't have to grab him around the neck, but good clinch. Yeah. See, he's seeing it coming. This is the problem about using a technique multiple times in a row. A good opponent will pick up on that, and they'll know how to defend. And yeah. Wang is looking absolutely exhausted here.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
If Persons put together some shots here at the end.
You know, I think, once again, the unorthodoxy got him through some tough areas this fight, but Perkins,
ooh, nice combo,
his technicality, his range, really ended up securing that fight. I'm not going to speak too soon because clearly you have no idea what the judges may be thinking tonight. But if I had to say, I would give that fight to Perkins. You know, the technical Muay Thai really showed through.
I'm going to have to agree with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have
the judges is definitely a mystery.
Chevy,
you know, so
Colorado,
what I've taken from this fight so far, Perkins definitely won those first.
There's one of them for Oregon.
It's round one, obvious, I give it a perk. Round three, I also give it a perk.
Thank you.
Round two, I do think Wang had a little bit more success in round two. So I'm not sure how the judges will swing on round two. But I got him 2-1 on this card.
Well. And again, the diversity of weapons that Perkins used. He was landing good knees in the clinch. He was landing low kicks, good punches. And I felt like Wang got a little single-minded there. You know, he would find a strike that would land, then he'd try it 3-4 times. When really, you've got to take breaks in between throwing strikes. You've got to throw a spinning back fist, then go back to your other stuff, set it up again, and then throw it instead of just, you know, the same strike over and over again. So I think that will probably... you know, showing the judge's eyes, so I see Perkins getting this victory.
You want to carry around that utility bag. Exactly. You got all those tools to pull out and use.
Judges one and two scored the bout 28-29, and judge number three scored it 27-30. For your winner, by unanimous decision, out of the blue corner, Justin Perkins!
We were on par with the judges in that one.
I would say so. Looks like a unanimous decision win for Perkins, moving his record to 4-5-1-1. 10,
ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Justin.
For our most veteran fighter on the card.